My name is Merrick Gertler, and it is my great privilege to serve the University of Toronto as its 16th president. Today, I have the additional privilege of assisting Chancellor Rose Patton in conducting this special honorary degree ceremony. I bid a warm welcome to everyone who has joined us virtually from around the globe. In compliance with public health directives in the province of Ontario to help stop the spread of COVID-19, we are conferring all honorary degrees virtually. In normal times, this ceremony would have occurred during a convocation ceremony, where we gather in person to celebrate the achievements of our U of T graduates and our honorary degree recipients together. And so I would like to thank our honorary graduate, Dr. David Colcleugh, for agreeing to accept the University of Toronto's highest honor under these unique circumstances. I would also like to thank Mr. Stephen Colcleugh for agreeing to serve as hooder, an important ceremonial role in the conferral portion of the convocation ceremony. It is now my great honor to present Dr. David Colcleugh. David Colcleugh holds a BASC, MASC, and PhD in chemical engineering and applied chemistry, all from the University of Toronto. He is a highly accomplished engineer and business leader whose contribution to engineering leadership education has been transformative. David Colcleugh's early, persistent, and powerful support as a teacher, mentor, champion, donor, and thinker was instrumental in the establishment of the Troost Institute for Leadership Education in Engineering, also known as ILEAD, at U of T in 2002. The Institute is at the forefront of engineering leadership education and research in North America, and Dr. Colcleugh's focus, expertise, and passion for raising every engineer's leadership potential have been essential to this success. ILEAD has brought major benefits to students, educators, practicing engineers, and engineering companies. Each year, thousands of undergraduates and hundreds of graduate students participate in its courses, workshops, and programs. Dr. Colcleugh gained much practical experience in leadership development during his distinguished career with the DuPont Company, where his exceptional record of corporate leadership saw him rise to the position of chair, president, and CEO of DuPont Canada. He was recognized as a strategic visionary leader dedicated to sustainability, and under his leadership, DuPont Canada became an industry leader in sustainable growth. Dr. Colcleugh was also instrumental in developing the principles of responsible care, the chemical industry's global voluntary initiative to improve continuously their health, safety, and environmental performance. Among many other accolades, Dr. Colcleugh has been recognized for his achievements and contributions with U of T's Engineering Alumni Medal. He has been inducted into the Engineering Hall of Distinction and is a fellow of the Canadian Academy of Engineering. For his outstanding service to the University of Toronto, through his pioneering and transformative contributions to leadership education and engineering, Chancellor Patton, on behalf of the Governing Council, I ask you to confer the degree of Doctor of Laws honoris causa upon David Colcleugh.
On behalf of the University of Toronto and by virtue of the authority vested in me, I have the great honor and pleasure of conferring on you, David William Colcleugh, the degree of Doctor of Laws honoris causa.
As the newest member of the University of Toronto alumni, Dr. Colcleugh, I extend warmest congratulations on behalf of the entire U of T community. I now invite you to deliver your address.
Ladies and gentlemen of the graduating class, it is with great pleasure I congratulate you on graduating from this, one of the world's great universities. I am pleased and honored the university has given me the opportunity to share some thoughts with you, only for a very few minutes. I will start by saying any success I have had in my career can be captured by five words. Change everything all the time. Contrary to that mantra, I have met too many talented people who do their best to avoid making or dealing with change in their lives. These are people who treat life and their careers as a game of roulette, looking for positive change to just happen and hoping to avoid as much as possible unwanted negative change that too often happens. And saying to themselves, please life, just send me a check every month and just leave me alone. Too many of these people too often rely on tools like luck and excuses. A better approach is to embrace change. Seek opportunities to make proactive, positive change. Think of positive change as a thing, a product to be manufactured in a designed process. A requirement of this design process is a high level of creative thinking and energetically learning new capabilities all the time. We can call this strategic change. If you just do it without creative thinking and learning new skills, then more than likely you are on a path to finding a different road to negative change. So change everything strategically all the time. That probably seems a little extreme to you, but think about your competitors, even the ones that don't exist yet. And mostly think about that great passive competitor, time. All these opponents are always looking for ways to take your business away from you. Maybe not immediately, but sooner than you think. In today's business, profit or non-profit, if you're not improving yourself and your business continuously, you are on a path to disappointment. I am confident all of you in this graduating class will not allow this to happen to you. And I will end here and wish all of you a long and happy career and life.
Thank you, Dr. Colcleugh, and let me say you have inspired us with your lifetime career and accomplishments, and today you have inspired us with your words. We are delighted to count you among the most distinguished members of our alumni community. In closing, I offer warm congratulations to you and to all the graduates of 2021.